Hi, it's your coach, Joe Lucas, and welcome to the second quarter of 2018. Hey, hope you had a good first quarter. And what I want to do in this video today is kind of walk you through a very streamlined review process. Last Friday, I hosted for our Magellan members a very intensive review and recap of the first quarter, and then all of us started to create our second quarter game plans. I'm going to share with you what that looks like in a moment. But here's where we are. 25% of 2018 is gone. The sunburn effect, if you will, of the 1st of January, right? The enthusiasm, the excitement, the I'm going to have my best year ever, for some of you may be waning a little bit. You know, our workouts may not be happening like we wanted them to anymore. Our nutritional goals may be a little sideways. So I've always found that working in a 90-day cycle, you know, a real periodization, if you will, has been really, really important, because I think most human beings can focus on 12 weeks, right? And so that's what we do. So here's step one. What you need to do, if you haven't already done so, and look, you don't have to do it today, but I think you do need to do it this week, is you need to sit down, pull out your business plan, assuming you have one, or goals, whatever it is you do to kind of get organized for the year. And you want to look at kind of where you are versus plan. So revenue goals, income goals, new client goals, asset goals, premium goals, whatever your metrics are, right, for yourself, right? You want to, hey, where are we? The second thing you want to do is you want to look at your execution, your habits, your activities. How well did I do with my morning success ritual first quarter? How well did I do with my written daily game plan first quarter? How did I do with introduction and referral conversations, right? Optimization, whatever the other KPIs, and KPIs just stand for key performance indicators. So things you want to measure in your business, both from a business perspective and also from a personal perspective, because you can also have personal KPIs, exercise minutes, calories burned, how much time you spend doing certain things. You want to have your hands around that. So the first thing we want to do. The second thing we're going to do is let's look at our marketing, our business development. So how do we do with, you know, with our newsletters, our voice, our outreach, our podcast, our video cast? How well do we do getting out there in the market? All right, you want to really take a feel for that. And then after you kind of get kind of, okay, here's where we are for the first quarter, well, what do we want to accomplish in quarter two of 2018? Now, for myself and for many of my clients, we use this very simple, and again, if you're on my YouTube channel, you'll see this. If you're on the podcast, visualize this, right? It's a very simple two-pager of all. This is what I personally use every 90 days, and this is what I walk my clients through every 90 days, is this very neat two-pager. This is what we review every day. For everybody here, what do you want to accomplish in the next 90 days? Revenue, new clients, assets, premium, production, referrals, centers of influence, whatever it is, come up with a plan for that. What are we going to do to get there? Are we doing seminars, reviews, podcasts, video casts, centers of influence? What are we doing in terms of, you know, getting out there? Because I will say this, you know, it's interesting, the last couple of weeks with the quote-unquote market volatility, quotes, I've always found that when, you know, things are like this, and I don't think there's anything sinister at work, is that it raises people's awareness. And I've always said that good markets hide all sins in our business, right? So what I mean by all sins, you know, not calling your clients, not reviewing them, not caring enough, being lazy, collecting your fee, doing the minimums. And look, let's face it. And I'm not saying this is 08-09. I don't think it's anything close to that. But as an industry, we're 10 years older. And for most people in this space, you know, who don't take care of themselves, I'm sorry. You know, the reality is a lot of people in this space, a lot of professionals are going to go past their prime. And they're not going to be doing what's necessary. Not only that, we have a lot of baby boomers retiring. You know, I've got clients that one of the KPIs we do, which is really cool, I'm going to share this with y'all, is we actually do an analysis of our clients who are 55 and older and figure out what their anticipated retirement date is, and then figure out what their current 401k assets are. And we run a report, or we put a report together, and we could see like almost every year, you know, $10, $15, $20, $30, $40 million kind of being available in rollover assets. I mean, that's a cool thing to know, especially when you know you've got RMDs going out the other side, right? Point is this, you know, you got to run your business and you got to know about things. Go play in, I have a term, go play in traffic. There's a lot of people that need help. There are a lot of advisors, quite frankly, that shouldn't be in this business anymore. I know, and I don't mean any disrespect to anybody watching or listening to me, but this is what these are my experiences, right? Make a decision. Either be in this business and be a pro and be your best, but don't hang around. Don't be a broker. Don't be a salesperson. Don't be that. You know, you're going to run out of runway, and I think you already know that. Make the second quarter, again, first quarter's over. What are we going to do in the next 90 days to be great? What are you going to do to help people? What are you going to do to grow your business? What are you going to do to improve yourself, right? What are the resources you need? You need to look at all that and have an honest conversation with yourself. Say, what do I need to do better? Don't let a whole year go by. Here's what people do. And I told my clients this. This was my premise on Friday. What do most advisors do? They do a business plan. Then they go a whole 12 months. And then they might look at it again. And they may say, oh man, I never got that done, or I failed at this, or that didn't happen. And at least every 90 days, you have four opportunities to change something versus one opportunity to change something. I mean, it's just common sense. I have a 400% improvement in my opportunity to do something different, to do something better. So, carve out some time, listen to this video again. Here's what I want you to look at, right? Kind of very superficially. Most of my clients, by the way, this is what we use for those of you watching. We actually have a whole process that we use every quarter. Benchmarks, KPIs, we go all through that. Do your version, that's cool. But make sure you go through your process, okay? Don't just kind of keep your head down and run and work hard, quote unquote. Put a lot of hours in and not know what direction you're in, right? Think of it that way. I need to get somewhere. I'm running real hard, but my head's down. I'm annoyed. I'm in motion, but am I in the right direction? Keep that in mind. Have a great day. I'll visit with you all again very soon.